please subscribe and don't forget to press the bell icon to get notified whenever we upload a new video.
So to discuss the outlook for FY19, we have Madhavan Menon, the CMD of the company, who joins us now. Thanks a lot, Mr. Menon, for joining in. While for travel companies, it's a seasonally weak quarter, you've had an eventful one with, you know, the demerger of, or rather, the decision to distribute Quest shares, and that is reflected in your bottom line as well, the exceptional there. So let's talk about your ex-Quest business in FY19, now that this is gone and done. What is your target in terms of revenue for FY19 coming from both organic and inorganic business? You've done close to around 2,500 crores in this quarter. Quarterly run rate for the next four quarters?
Good morning, Mangalam. I think let me sort of declutter the data that we've put out there, mm-hmm. So that there is some degree of clarity on what we've done. So first of all, I think this particular set of results contains a lot of one-offs, and we need to remove those to be ensure that we see a like-to-like. So if we look at on a consolidated basis and we remove the non-cash profit of 5,800 crores that we got as a result of moving the Quest shares from the book value to fair value. The second one was earlier this year we made a couple of acquisitions, and we have taken a couple of write-offs to clean those books. So that's approximately another 22 crores. A third item is that our quarter, the January, February, March quarter, consolidates Quest for 1 month, okay, and deconsolidates Quest for the other 2 months. Now, if I were to take comparable numbers, our profitability, despite being an investment quarter, has actually grown by 9%. Now, this is attributed to a variety of reasons. First of all, our inbound business had an excellent quarter. If you look at the Sterling Holiday Resorts, their losses actually halved.
Right.
Thirdly, despite being an investment quarter in the travel businesses, we've actually managed our costs much better. Okay. And we had a decent October, November, December quarter in the travel space. So we were actually able to close the files and book profits in January. So, you know, overall, I think it's been a good performance on a like-to-like basis. But as you very rightly said, these numbers are cluttered up because of the one-offs. Now, to answer your question on the way going forward, I think if I look at my forward bookings, which is in the travel business, the outbound travel business, both SOTC and Thomas Cook on a blended basis are running their forward bookings 34% above last year. Now, even if I were to factor in some element for the depreciation in the rupee, we're still talking 28 to 30% growth, which I think is a very good indicator. We have not seen such strong growth in nearly 2 years. And I can attribute this to two reasons. One, you know, we've used analytics quite extensively to manage our leads. Secondly, we're also, you know, brought out new products which are focused on a variety of different segments. So, you know, for example, the regional tours, you know, those have taken off significantly this year. So I'm looking at the next couple of quarters.
All right.
Last point that you made on Quest going out, you know, we are already factoring it out, Mangalam, and my expectation is that what we call the Quest burn in our system would have disappeared and would be replaced by two things. One, if you remember the October, November, December quarter, we did the OFS sale. So over the last 6 years, we had invested close to 1,000 crores in acquisitions. 541 has come back.
Absolutely.
Now, we'll use this to reduce our working capital. And that will bring about interest and working capital benefits to the tune of 3 to 4 crores a quarter.
Okay.
So, you know, my expectation is that we'll be able to offset all these numbers and it will not look significantly
different. So, Mr. Menon, sir, we have heard what you had to say, sir. 3 to 4 crores a quarter, your finance cost for last year was around 37 crores. So, you mean that the finance cost will come down to sub 30 crores, maybe towards 25 crores?
Yeah.
All right. Okay. Yeah. So that's one point, sir. The other point I wanted to ask you.
It will drop significantly.
Okay. All right. Point taken, sir. In terms of your financial services business, that's a smaller part of your business. Wanted to ask you a couple of questions. One is, will you be looking to apply for an NBFC license? Point number one. And point number two, will you unlock value for your shareholders? Will you look at demerging this business? Is that a possibility?
Mangalam, first of all, the foreign exchange business is the cash cow in the entire portfolio
Absolutely.
Of the Thomas Cook Group. We have no intention of demerging it. It is a core business for us, and it will remain where it is. And you know, that's the way it is structured, and we will not change that. As far as an NBFC is concerned, very honestly, at this point of time, we do not. We've examined the possibility, but we've actually come up to the view that that's not our core business. We don't want to get into that.
All right.
But, you know, I don't want to say never, because
never
acquisition
never.
Opportunities yeah. may come along the
way. So are you looking at applying for an NBFC license,
NBFC
Mr. Menon?
NBFC or a service business, I don't. No, not at all. Not
Cox
at all.
& Kings, your competitor, has done that. So would you not want to follow that?
Never say never, I think.
Never say
Mr.
never.
Mr. Menon is telling us
well,
that.
Well, you know... No, but my competitors do, competition does lots of things which I don't do. So right. let's put this to the fact that we won't do that.
Okay.
And finally...
Not for the same
right,
reasons
all right,
at least.
All right. Finally, Mr. Menon, before we let you go, you know, can we see profitability come by in the sterling business in the next year? And what's your target out there for the operational gains coming in from sterling business?
So I think the good news in all this is sterling. Where they're now firmly back, despite, I know I've given assurances of this kind in the past, but if you look at their EBITDA numbers, they're beginning to show a turnaround. My expectation is that the structural changes which they went through last year, they continue to implement right as we go forward in terms of costs, are beginning to pay off. And on an EBITDA basis, you will actually see them back in a profit either this coming quarter or the next quarter.
Okay, all right, Mr. Menon. Thanks so much,
sir. I'm willing to...